Welcome, woodworkers of the world, to the Swedish knife grip sessions. Today we're going to talk about a very useful knife grip for smoothing and clean cutting surfaces when you want them to be really nice and carved. Then we're using the thumb grip. It goes like this. I'm steering the knife away from me, holding it like this in my hand, and I'm kind of pushing with the other hand's thumb at the same time as I'm squeezing the material in between my fingers. I'm pushing with my thumb on the back of the blade to get to have a cut. You see, the knife is slightly angled. It can be like that, but cuts much better if it has a little angle like this. Very often, I'm actually using three ways of doing this grip. Pushing is one part, but in another way, I can also place my thumb down here, where the blade meets the handle, and steer the blade to the side. By doing that, I can slice better in the wood, so the knife goes sideways, which helps the cut to be go easier in the wood. At the same time, I can also pivot the knife on the top of the thumb. So you see, it kind of rolls on the top and pivots, so I get some extra leverage and power by doing that. And at the same time as I'm pivoting, I'm kind of steering the thumb to the side like this. So this is a very useful and very common grip when you are carving. In this thumb grip, you have to be assure that all the movements that you do is kind of helping you while you are carving. So in this case, steering the knife sideways, you have to rotate your elbow at the same time. So notice how my elbow comes out in the beginning, and then I'm placing my thumb right there, and then I'm kind of rotating everything around the thumb, so the elbow has a little clearance on the side here. Then it's working much better. So you see, I'm kind of working with my shoulders a lot too, like this. So don't be afraid to exaggerate the motion in here, because that helps you to be strong and efficient like that. So if I want to clean cut the back of a spoon blade, for example, I start here and then I make one long bevel all the way out to the tip, so I know that that bevel is controlled. And then I take another row on the side of that one, which is also clean and nice. So I can actually see two bevels, you know, with a little ridge in between them following each other. And this helps me to control the form and to see the shape much better. And also, I know that I've clean-cutted all the surfaces all the way. And you can see I'm using different ways of rotating the knife and steering it. And sometimes I'm pushing it sideways, like I just told you. So this way is a really good way for the final clean cutting of a spoon to make it smooth and nice in the very beginning. Also, remember to press the knife down in the wood so you have support from the bevel on the outside. This is very important. So this was the thumb grip, and this was made by pushing sideways for the sliding, and the pivoting part when rotating over the thumb like that. In many various combinations, you can do this one, and it will help you to clean cut the surfaces so they get becomes very smooth and nice.